Criteo, the performance marketing technology company, has published its results for the first half of 2016. We're going to have a closer look in particular at the second quarter results with Eric Eichmann. Hello.
Hello.
You are the CEO of Criteo. You've just closed this other, the new strong quarter. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Indeed, Q2 was a very strong quarter of profitable growth. We continued to execute on both our plans for growth and operating leverage, and innovation and focused execution fueled that growth. Our results exceeded guidance for the 11th quarter in a row. Revenue ex-TAC grew at constant currency at 35%, and EBITDA grew at 61% at constant currency.
Tell us a little bit more about what you believe your main achievements were in the second quarter.
So we perform well across all areas. The first area of growth is technology innovation. Mobile, a key area there, now represents over 50% of our revenue ex-TAC. And in particular there, the in-app business grew over sevenfold versus last year. We also continue to roll out our universal match technology. We now have over two-thirds of our clients that are participating in building a pooled cross-device graph. And then of those users that are matched, we're matching the most valuable ones. They represent about 47% of the revenue ex-TAC. And all of that, all of these technology innovations are leading to 14% growth year over year for existing clients. The second area is expanding publisher relationships. One of the key areas there, of course, is our relationship with Facebook, where we now have 6,000 clients connecting through us to buy inventory on Facebook. We also turned on Instagram last quarter, where we have over 4,000 clients. And there's a general movement for native inventory. So we're actually seeing good growth on native inventory ex Facebook. We're seeing over 50% or about 50% growth over Q1. And then finally, we're connecting to a lot of in-app inventory, in particular in Asian app-heavy markets. And that's the second area. And the third area is new clients. We added over 900 clients on the quarter. We're seeing a lot of those coming, of course, from mid-market, but mid-market remains a very, very large opportunity for us as we are only under 15% penetrated in that market. We're seeing 70% growth year on year for mid-market. And as we're doing all of this, mid-market revenue per client or revenue ex-TAC per client continues to grow.
Let's have a look now region by region at how the second quarter went.
So the Americas is the largest contributor to growth this quarter with 38% at constant currency. In the Americas, we're seeing very good growth from mid-market at around 70%. We also have a challenging geography in Brazil, so we're seeing lower growth there. EMEA grew very well. It's a more mature region for us. It grew at 25% at constant currency, and we're seeing solid growth from mature markets within EMEA, in particular Germany. And then we're also seeing, we're signing large clients in Spain, for example. We signed a large apparel client we're very pleased with. And then travel clients continue to expand their business in EMEA. So that's quite encouraging. And then APAC was the fastest growing region for us. It grew at 50%. We're seeing very strong growth from new business in India and Japan. Talking about India, we just opened the office in India, and we're seeing large clients being signed in India, so we're very excited about that. And then Southeast Asia continues to be a very big driver of growth. We grew at 80%. And then finally, China, we're seeing good progress in building the domestic business there.
Looking forward, what do you expect your main areas of focus to be for the second half of 2016?
So four key priorities for us. Number one is continue to innovate on our core platform. A key part of that in the second part of the year is building the infrastructure to make sure we take advantage of the cross-device graph in our core engine. So that's the first area. The second area is continue to expand on new sources of inventory, in particular native, social, and mobile. Third area is strengthening our position in APAC. It remains a very, very large opportunity. And Southeast Asia and China, as well as India, are three key geographies that are quite promising for us. And then finally, continuing to develop new products, in particular shopping within the search environment, which is an area that we've been investing in. So in short, I'm very pleased with our strong Q2 results. Our performance combines high growth with improved profitability. And we continue to execute on our plans and have exciting new products in the pipeline.
Eric Eichmann, CEO of Criteo, thank you very much.
Thank you.